We're at Electric Lady Studios, and it's always wonderful to be here to get the vibe again. Jimmy's spirit always lives in this building. It brings me back to when we were here, Jimmy and I, listening to tapes from that period. I didn't realize that there was so much more. This new album called Both Sides of the Sky, it's material that I really wish I'd heard before. I mean, when we were doing our research and digging through the archives, we came across all these gems, and it's fabulous material. We started this whole process with Valleys of Neptune, and then we went to People, Hell, and Angels. Those two albums were very successful. The material was really exciting and raw, and it was such a pleasure. You know, you put the faders up, and there's Jimmy's sound in your face, and it's exciting. And I think the fans will just go nuts when they hear this, because this is undiscovered material. Out of the 13 songs, 10 have basically never been heard. Certainly not in the format that they are now. There was an exuberance to the creative process. He had a concentration that was unstoppable. You know, he knew what he was doing from the moment he hit the first chord. This is the direction of the song. This is what it's going to sound like. And this is my vision of it. And he wouldn't stop until he got there. And he said, the rules are, there are no rules. And man, did we, that just said to us, come on, let's do anything we can to make this music alive. Anything you can do to broaden its appeal, give it as much expanse as you can. Try anything you want. If it sounds great, great. But even if it doesn't sound great, we'll still try it. This feeling that I have, it's the ultimate feeling of satisfaction that I've been able to serve the music and serve Jimmy's memory and give it another lift, you know, and give it another day to shine. And if fans love it, great. I've done my job. I feel very satisfied.